Hi guys, this is Kumar from Kumar Resin Works, and today we'll do a video tutorial on how to make ocean art using Hexsense high gloss resin. Keep watching. This is the resin which I'll be using today. This is a new resin which is launched by Hexsense. It's a high gloss resin, and as they say, this resin can be used for single coat. So if you want to make a coasters, you can definitely use this resin. You can say it's a two-in-one resin. If you want to do a ocean pour or any pour which is having single coat, and you can also use this as, let's say, a top coat, and also can be used as a coaster resin. So let's go ahead and check this resin. Ocean pour tutorial. So this is a pine wood base which I'll be using for this tutorial, and I have already taped the edges. As you can see, I have masked the edges completely so that if at all, if I pour resin and you know it drips down, so I don't have it stays at the edge of the tape, you know, tape, so that once the resin is completely cured, I can just take care of the tape and you will have a clean back base. And for the new resin artist, so for this project I'll just give you a list of material which I'll be using this for this particular project. So the resin and the hardener, and I'll be using just two pigment for this. The one is the topaz blue from Hexsense, and the opaque white from Hexsense. So these are the opaque pigments which I'll be using, and I'll be using a butane torch. You can use some gloves, so it will be safe, you know, if you want to spread the resin, so you can wear the gloves. You can have some tissues, some wooden ice cream sticks to mix the resin and the colors, and some paper cups. Okay, so yeah, and as well as a hair dryer to push the wave and to make the patterns. So let's go ahead and start. I'll show you how to mix the resin and what are the procedures that need to be followed while mixing the resin. And I just want to inform you that there is a brilliant application which is available for both the operating system from Boreal is resin calculator. So that will help you to calculate and you know, take the amount of resin and hardener which you need for your project. So just try to install that application, and that will be really helpful. So as I said, I have 90 gram of resin, so let's make it zero again and take 45 gram of hardener. Almost 50, so let's make it zero, and I'll add some 10 ml of resin, because so don't worry about if you take 3 to 4 gram of extra resin or a hardener, so nothing will happen. But don't exceed more than 10 mm, so that, you know, while curing, so there might be some kind of issues. So it might not cure, or if it, you know, it might stay sticky. So that's the reason I'm asking you to, you know, take the proportion equally. Always use a kitchen weighing scale. And when you mix the resin and hardener, make sure you scrape the edges of the cup, because the resin is always heavier compared to the hardener. So make sure you scrape the edges properly from the sides of the cup, and also from the bottom of the cup. Give a good mixture or a stir for at least 3 to 4 minutes, so that now you mix the resin and hardener well. And so how exactly you will get to know whether the resin and hardener has mixed well? So one thing, you have to mix for at least 3 to 4 minutes, and the resin itself will become crystal clear. That, you know, confirms that the resin and hardener has mixed properly. It will become completely clear. There won't be, you know, you cannot see any kind of transparent thread-like texture inside the resin. So that is the unmixed resin with the hardener. So just make sure you mix it really well, and so that you'll get a proper glossy finish once the resin is completely cured. Do whenever I work on any kind of base, make sure your base is completely prepared well. So this is a pine wood, as I told you initially. So as you can see, I have prepared my base by applying a thin coat of resin on this, so that when I do a final coat on this, the wood won't soak the extra resin. So you can do it for MDF, HDF, or any kind of a natural wood which you're using. But you don't have to do this preparation if you're working on a glass, acrylic, WPC, or a PVC board, or any non-porous surface. You don't have to do any preparation until unless you paint the base with acrylic color. But this is how you prepare the natural wood before you do the final pour. So I normally apply a thin coat of resin on the surface, so that the surface won't soak in any extra resin when you do the final pour. It's been almost 5 minutes, guys, and as I told you, so the resin and the hardener might have already blended well. And as you can see here, it is still clear. So yeah, and it is still in liquidy form. So right now you can start mixing the colors, and let's start making the ocean pour. So for this, as I said, I'll be taking only two colors. So one is white. So white we won't be using much, because it is just a simple wave. So this is for white. And this one is for the turquoise blue. Yep. So this is the amount of white pigment I'll be using for making the wave. Yep. And this is the amount of blue which I'll be taking for the water part. Mix well for at least 30-40 seconds, until the color completely, you know, mixes well with the resin. Yeah. Mix white also. So while mixing, you make sure you take out, you know, there are some colors which will be sticked your wooden stick. So just make sure you mix the colors really well. So because the unmixed colors, sometimes they might not, you know, cure when the resin cures. and it might end up being sticky. So make sure you mix the colors really, really well. Now that I have both the colors ready, so I will pour the blue first and followed by white, and let's make a gorgeous wave. So I'll be covering only half of, I can say 3/4 of this base with the water part that is further from the blue. Don't over pour the blue part, because sometimes if you over cover the base color, there are chances the white will settle down. So make sure you pour only sufficient amount of blue. So now that we have spread the blue evenly on the surface, make sure the base which you have placed is properly flat enough. Okay, so now let's pour the white and make some gorgeous waves. Okay, so always make sure you make a beak like this when you pour the white, and gently put a thin line at the horizon of blue. So once the white is poured, so normally as per my workflow, I heat the white a little bit using my butane torch until you see a tiny little cells. As you can see, there are really tiny cells which is breaking up. Now you can take your hair dryer, put it in a hot air settings, and then you just push the white as much as you want. I have some air bubbles here, so let me go ahead and get rid of those air bubbles. Leave it as it is for at least 5 minutes. Give it some time. You can see some cells breaking in slowly, but give some time and the cells will break up, break really, really slow. And as I said, if the cells doesn't break, so try to heat, take the butane torch, wave it like a brush on the surface for like 2 to 3 seconds, so the cells which is really stubborn, and it will start breaking, and you'll get a beautiful cells. So I'll show you how exactly the cells have is showing up as of now in this project. Hey guys, I hope this video tutorial will definitely help you to make some amazing artworks, ocean arts. If you have any question you have, you can mention in the comments. I'll try my best to answer all the comments, all the question you have. And most of the most common question which I get is how to cover your artwork. So use a big plastic tub or make your own plastic a cage kind of a thing, so you can protect the entire piece. And that's it. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial, and please tag Kumar Resin Works and Bohri Ali once you're done with your project, and I wish you all the best. Thank you. Bye bye.